I don't know what happened. I definitely was not in any danger. I think it was just a weird game of telephone, for chance.
Yo, Minx was trying to get back at him for the when he like guessed her weight during Name Your Price. He's trying to get back, or she's trying to get back at him. She was wasted, but she was on a mission. She saw blood. She saw red. What's up, Hellish? We're just going over really unfortunate drama that's going on that went on at the Streamer Awards with Minx getting too drunk and getting the after party shut down.
We're like, all right, shoot. And
but other than that, it's going great.
Like, what if I'm just sucking your dick?
Oh.
When the camera pans to you.
Wait, what is this? What's going on? What's happening? What you didn't see at the Streamer Awards, okay?
I was like, hey, when I come up for the award, I want to do something funny. And they were like, all right, shoot. And Cook was like, what if I'm just sucking your dick when the camera pans to you? What if I am just sucking your cock?
Like, that would have been good content.
Like, my head is bouncing up and down. And then I come up with a phone. Like I was looking for a phone.
Would have been 10 out of 10.
Like, I'll do it too.
Yes.
So what you didn't
Caroline's
see.
Caroline's such a G.
When they cut to me and my face was doing this. Was Caroline and Cook frantically sucking my cock or pretending to suck my cock. And the cameraman was like crying, laughing. He like could not hold it together. But little did we know, he cropped the phone.
Oh, man.
So you guys couldn't see me
lesson three.
Receiving fellatio.
That sucks.
We worked so goddamn hard on this bit.
You know, I'm waiting. This brings up another topic. Oh, what up, Yurio? True. The Streamer Awards did get one guide by Minx. But this clip, what did this just remind me of?
I was frantic, and the cameraman could not hold it together. But little did we know,
I forget. I had something I was going to say about this. What was it?
I'll do it, too. So what you didn't see when they cut to me and my face was doing this...
What was I gonna say? I had something I was gonna say about this.
Frantically sucking my cock or pretending to suck my cock.
Oh, I remember.
And the camera.
So this was for Will when they were nominated for the League of Their Own. NMP, Will, then Doug, and then who was the other person? Oh, Ludwig. I thought Ludwig was gonna win just because of his YouTube presence, you know, just like how he won the Streamer of the Year last year. It's so different. Being a Twitch streamer, talking about you're nominated for something, telling your audience to go vote for you versus making a YouTube video that gets millions and millions of views over weeks at a time and people go and vote. But I'm excited to see NMP go live for the first time since the Streamer Awards because that person, Doug, won the award and it was just like, what? Who's this person? I know he's probably got a huge audience and a lot of people know him, but... most people, I feel like, were like, who? Omega Lul? Like, what? And I saw NMP tweet something where he said, what did he say? Let me go find it real quick. LOL. He tweeted on his main or was it his alt? Oh, no. It must have been his alt. On. Oh no, where did it go? Oh, this night has been something else. I'm gonna keep it real. I don't think he was talking about how it was something else, like it was the most wild and amazing night. I think we're going to get a huge NMP rant when he comes back to stream being like, what was this, the YouTube awards? Was this the award for YouTubers or was this the awards for live streamers? Because it seemed to me, and I felt the same way, that people that kept winning, it was like, yeah, some of these people stream on Twitch, but like the org, like OTV, it's like, bro, go look at their YouTube. There's like nothing there for like Twitch content. It's all YouTube. It's all YouTube. That's it. They don't do any kind of like Twitch events. It's like, these are supposed to be the live streamer awards. This isn't like the streamies, the content creation awards. This is the live streamer awards. It's for Twitch streamers, bro. You go over to YouTube, you're going to get Who Omegalold. Yeah, maybe you'll win some awards, but like, for the most part, it's for Twitch streamers or live streamers. And like, to see so many people that just...
Your dick's small.
Oh my God, that scared me. Holy fuck, dude. Woo! Boonie with the 100 biddies. That fucking got me. That one's loud as fuck. Holy shit. But yeah, small peepee game. We have micro peepees around here. But yeah, it's just interesting. And I think we're going to get NMP going on a huge rant about it being the YouTuber awards versus the live streamer awards. Yeah, micro gang all the way. All the way. All right, let's keep going. Oh, what up, Volk?
Drinking it, and people will like try to help, but they don't actually help. I'm not throwing people under the bus, okay? I don't know what really happened. This is my perspective about the people that are around Minx over the years, over the months, or I guess that I've known. People will like, you know, be like, oh, like stop drinking, but they're not like actually helping at all. Well, I mean, bro, stop. It's just how it is, okay? It's just my view on it, okay? And then I was across, and then she kept drinking. Yeah? And then after that, what happened is that, you know, she just drank too much. She just drank too much. That's it. And then some stuff was getting broken or something like that. And the party was kind of like getting crazy, I guess. So they had to like put it out front. And then they got people to help. And then they helped, and they're like, yo, bro, nah, we're done with this shit. And they just...
Oh my God, Boonie with the other 100 biddies, thank you so much. That one is even louder. Holy fuck, that scared me. Woo! Oh my God, okay. Thank you for the 100 biddies.
And his name is John Cena!
Ooh, lovely lady with the 100 biddies! Oh, thank you. Holy shit. Oh my God. Woo! Okay, but back to what he was just saying. That's exactly what I was saying a few minutes ago. Like, it's obvious Minx does not have the right people around her to help her through what she's going through. It's 1 a.m. here. I was tired. Thank you for making it so I don't need... Oh, there you go. Now you're awake. Thank you, Boonie. That one is the worst. Glad I live alone.
Rara.
You mean you guys aren't listening through headphones? Rara. You guys got your speakers Rara. On? Uh-oh.
What?
I see him. He's in the corner of my room. Stop, please. Please go away.
Boo.
Ah! Oh, lovely lady. Oh shit, with the 400 biddies? Okay. All right. Let's go. Yo, thank you guys. Appreciate that. If I were headphones, I'd be wearing them 24 hours a day. Okay, for sure. Imagine if you didn't live alone and your device is connected to the Bluetooth speaker downstairs. Anybody ever, you know that, like, that functionality you can have on your phone where you can just, like, send whatever you're watching on your phone over to your smart TV? Anybody ever been watching the hub and accidentally done that? That ever happened to you? That definitely happened to me before. It's definitely happened to me. 100%. Okay, back to this. Mizkif's message to new juicers / Mizkids.
A lot of juicers don't even know, and maybe a lot of my viewers don't even know too. We go way back. Like, we go, me and XUC go back 5 years almost. We go way back. And I think a lot of people think that, like, oh, me and him never were friends. We don't like each other. We never knew. It's just completely false. He used to live right next to me. We used to hang out. He, in my opinion, we had one of the best IRL streams ever, which is when he was stuck downtown and me and Poke went and saved him.
Okay.
You know?
I didn't see any of that.
It was a, we had good times, man.
I never saw any of that back
then.
We
had good times. And
that was before I was into watching chatting stuff.
It made me so happy. It made S-Fan happy too. S-Fan was like, this is what I always wanted. Like, he was, chat, we don't want problems. We're all human. And at one point, it's me.
Okay, whatever. XQC tries to start a poll. Will Neff on being complimented by Jerma?
His Lifetime Achievement Awards. He said during his speech, there are a lot of you out there that are pushing the platform, and you got to keep going, and you got to keep making cool stuff. And I was like, that is so awesome, dude. He's so fucking cool. His speech was incredible. So after the Streamer Awards.
That's for a cool.
Thank you so much. I ran down to congratulate Hassan.
Nice, Volk.
Because obviously, you know, it's my best friend, and he won a great award. And I wanted to dap him up. And Jerm was sitting next to him, and I went up, and I was like,
ooh, thank you, Ramen.
Dude. Unbelievable. Unreal. So cool, deserved. And he's like, I don't know. I get, he's always so humble. He's always so fucking humble. And he was like, but by the way, it's like, you're one of those guys I'm talking about. Keep making stuff.
Aw.
Keep pushing.
Oh, yeah, wow. That's for
And
cool.
I just felt my heart like, and I was like, oh, my God, dude, that's the coolest shit I've ever heard in my life. And I honestly got choked up. I was like, holy.
Charming Joe explains how he vomited before performing at the Streamer Awards.
It was like, DM me, where you at? Where you at? I couldn't reply. I found out after before. I'm so sorry about
Ooh,
that.
Ooh, nice, Volk.
In a backstage was going crazy because I vomited right before to perform. And I don't, they kind of like talked to each other through the, you know, they must be, you know. And then Maya was rent to me, and like Maya was staring at me like this and like, Joe, are you sure you can perform? Are you okay? Are you okay? Are you okay? Do you think that you can perform? Do you want to switch with Nikki's turn? And I was like,
this is funny.
Dude, what am I doing this shit? They got my plane tickets and they got my hotels, and dude, I should do it, Joe. I should do it.
Of course.
I should fucking do
why
it.
Why is he? Why is it like? Why is he acting like he gave the most like breathtaking performance?
I think I get
it was like a comedy performance. So. Charming Joe's a great singer, but like that was like it was like funny.
And Maya was saying,
it wasn't like oh my god, this is like so moving. It was like meme. It was a meme the whole time. Hassan finally grants E-Rob peace.
Oh damn.
Yes!
Oh my god, that was Woo! So loud. Jesus Christ.
That's what I'm fucking talking about, baby. The meme is dead. That's gonna fucking kill it, man.
What
that
meme?
That right there's gonna fucking kill it. Let's
Ooh,
go.
Ooh, lovely
baby.
Lady with that nothing Let's redemption. Let's go. No, Boonie, I don't watch the Oscars. You know, there's this thing called this show called On Cinema at the Cinema with Tim Heidecker and Greg Turkington, and they do this show every year where they host the Oscars, kind of like how I hosted the Streamer Awards. But their whole point is like they're obsessed with the Oscars. And the whole thing is, like, they're going to be watching it, but the whole show is them just, like, never getting to actually watching the Oscars and just, like, all this crazy shit going on. That's what I usually watch. I didn't watch it this year. That's usually what I watch instead of the Oscars. Let's see. Cutie Cinderella's event fixes relations. I'm good. AI creator gets Rickrolled by his own spawn. DJ Academics does a thing.
Early in the stream, I was like, yo, my top five is Drake, 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 Drake. And then they just, they go to the part, I'm like, yo.
Okay. Let's see. Poke trying to plug LAN cable, but has no spots left. Jesse laughing his ass off.
Hey, brother. How long is it to plug your fucking monitor in?
There's no more spots left.
Yo, I want to do streams like this, where you guys come like Fourth and Zoop, Ramen, all you guys are here. Behind me at the desk. We got a desk back here. We're doing LAN games. Okay. Time to put Austin back.
You know, I think he has fully embraced this diva, high maintenance, gay queen version of himself. You know what? Put him back in the closet. All right. He is chaotically gay now. Yeah. I'm going to stick his ass back in the closet.
Let's go. Hassan confronted by an expert.
Those women with nice boobs and curves would look good in this you are idiot, Lamout, implying Hassan knows anything about fashion, Lamout. Yeah. Guys,
I'm going to be real. I love Hassan. But the whole going over everybody's fits at the Streamer Awards and being like, oh my God, this was a 10 out of 10. Oh my God, this was not good. This didn't work. This just didn't match the theme of the night. So fucking cringe, dude. I said it while we were watching the Hassan fashion stream. I just think fashion like that is so cringe. Seer and Peach looked the best. They were the best. And last year, when Hassan and his brother showed up in like their Western outfits, the best. And then Poke and XQC and all them. Best fits of the fucking night other than Seer and Peach. Let's see. Let me go to their fits real quick. Fuck all that dressing up in a suit, getting a nice gown. Fuck all that. It's so cringe. These were the best right here, right there. Seer and Peach. The best. And then, where's, Poke, XQC, Jesse, Gigi. Just dripped out. Dripped out. And his outfit last year was better, and the outfit that he bought the night before the Streamer Awards was better, too. The Japanese, like, samurai style outfit that he got, that was sick. But Cutie apparently had some kind of a sponsorship with the tux or the suit company that Hassan was wearing, and they convinced him to wear it. And I even heard Valkyrie on his stream. Valkyrie was like begging Hassan not to wear that outfit that he bought the night before. And like, I don't get that. It looked so much better than just wearing a suit. I don't know. You'll never catch me. Like, I dressed up how I dressed, but that suit that I was wearing, the suit jacket, like, it doesn't even fit me. It wasn't even mine. It was, somebody gave it to me. Like, I'm never gonna wear a suit. I am, like, against wearing suits. I'm afraid of people that wear suits, okay? 100%. But Peach, Seer, XQC, and crew, they know what's up. Um, Hassan confronted by an, oh wait, yeah, we didn't
going
finish
forward,
this one.
Mr. Booba Lover, most women with nice boobs.
Oh, is it Dolce and Gabbana? Okay.
In this, you are idiot, Lamont, implying Hassan.
Very questionable.
About fashion, Lamont.
And you're afraid. Yeah. I guess so, Volk.
Guys, going forward, this is the Mr. Booba Lover broadcast. I've decided Mr. Booba Lover is the actual knowledgeable party here. I want to apologize for the direction that I took when I tried to have an opinion about fashion. Mr. Booba Lover is actually the foremost authority on fashion.
God, fashion is,
and,
I don't get
surprisingly,
it.
Surprisingly, all things booba, actually.
Like, you'll never catch me saying, I don't know. We're done with that topic. Perfect timing for Raiders. Minus 24K.
What would have happened if someone took the KFC sponsor prize? They get the money. I don't know why no one did. I'm genuinely so confused. I don't know why nobody took the money. They would have just gotten the money. Chat would have still gotten the prize, is what's crazy.
Oh, nice, Volk. Wait, hold on. I missed it.
What would have happened if someone took the KFC sponsor prize? They get the money. I don't know why no one did. I'm genuinely so confused. I don't know why nobody took the money. They would have just gotten the money. Chat would have still gotten the prize, is what's crazy.
I don't think so. I don't think that's. I thought the whole joke was like, you're not supposed to take the money. Just keep doubling it.
Like,
really? Was that for real? Did somebody really miss? I didn't think they were actually going to give anybody the money. World is healing, Trainwrecks and Hassan bridge in the works. No fucking way.
Oh man, I don't even know if he could do all that, but I get it, and I understand. Like, listen, I've always thought you are not above criticism. I think you do receive some fair criticism, but I think ultimately you do receive a lot of criticism that's like not fair.
That's
so
bullshit. Yeah, no, 100%. And you know, I think
he's
at times
talking
I felt,
to Train.
You know, that maybe it was coming from his end, and maybe he was playing to certain narratives. But kind of looking into it and stepping back, you know, I do see a little consistency in certain areas, you know, from him, and I see a little bit more consistent. You know, like for example, in the Streamer Awards, I saw him hold his ground. Like, what made me want to message him today was I saw him hold his ground with certain people that, you know, he, you know, had certain opinions about online, but in person he held his ground, right? He may have been civil, and you know, he may have been courteous. And
like, who?
And
I want to. Okay,
it,
you know what?
But he held his ground, right?
I want to watch this.
Kind of just.
I want to. Oh, VOD unavailable. Fuck.
No, if he could do all that, but I get it, and I understand. Like,
damn it! Listen. I wanted to watch that. That's some good shit right there. I want to know who he was talking about specifically. Like, who he was saying he saw Hassan like hanging out with people that he's criticized. Like, is he talking about, like, Mizkif and Maya? Like, Hassan was so open about that. He was like, yo, I think good people can do bad things. And, like, Hassan, being the unbiased person that he is going to talk about that kind of stuff. And he's not going to ignore it just because his friends did it. You know, he's going to talk about it and give it the time that it needs. But is that what Train is saying? Like, oh, I saw him, like, being buddy-buddy with Mizkif. And it's like, yeah, like,
I do see a little consistency in certain areas, you know, from him, and I see a little bit more consistent. You know, like, for example, in the Streamer Awards, I saw him hold his ground. Like, what made me want to message him today was I saw him hold his ground with certain people that, you know, he, you know, had certain opinions about online, but in person he held his ground, right?
Oh,
he might,
really?
He may have been civil, and, you know, he may have
he's gonna go
been
on fear
and decent and mature about it.
Nice.
But he held his ground, right? Mm. Whereas others kind of just.
Oh man!
Well, you guys want to know where the real issue between Hassan and Trainwreck started? Like, they've always been like going back and forth on things. They've debated things back in the day. There's YouTube videos of Hassan, Destiny, XQC, and Trainwreck like playing games together, and they'll sit there and like debate like capitalism over socialism, and Hassan and Trainwreck would be going at it, and but they were always friends at the end of the day. You want to know what really drove a wedge between their friendship? Austinox. And I don't think Austinox did anything wrong. Austinox was like rightfully calling out Trainwrecks and things like that. But I remember specifically when Austinox started to come at Trainwrecks and just gambling in general, Train got really mad and started being like, Hassan, you need to fucking put a leash on your editor, bro. You need to rein him in. And Hassan's like, bro, he's an editor. Like, I'm not asking him to do any of this. He's his own person. Like, I'm not going to tell him to stop, like, criticizing gambling or, like, maybe you specifically. But that even brings up a bigger point. No, like, Hassan and Pokimane, none of them were, like, coming at Train Wrecks and being like, yo, you're bad. You're bad for doing this. Maybe every once in a while they would say things about, like, people promoting gambling, this unregulated crypto gambling to their audience, but they were never specifically being like, Train is a bad fucking person. There were people saying that, but they weren't themselves. What they were doing was coming after the unregulated crypto gambling that was a scam. It was scamming people. And then that got banned, rightfully so. But none of the other kind of gambling that is regulated got banned, and that's because it's regulated. There's stuff in place stopping gambling addicts from spending all their money, which is like they literally have like things in place on those websites where like if you're a gambling addict, you opt into it, and then it stops you from ever being able to gamble on that website again. There's checks and balances when it comes to signing up. If you're in a state where it's illegal, you're not allowed to sign up. If you're a kid that's under the age of 18, you can't sign up. Whereas the unregulated crypto gambling that people like Trainwreck and them were selling to their audience was illegal. If you were in a state where it was illegal, you could sign up. If you were a kid, you could sign up and then you wouldn't get paid out. You could go and spend money and gamble, but then when it came to getting your winnings, they wouldn't pay you out because it was illegal. It was a scam. So that's what everybody was coming at. There were people that were specifically like hating on Trainwreck for promoting it, and I don't see anything wrong with that, but they were really like Trainwreck really just had this chip on his shoulder that Pokimane and Hassan were trying to come after me specifically. It's like that's not what it was. It was never like that. But wait, what did I miss? Oh shit, my bad. I missed stuff for a few minutes. But I got you Gucci flip-flops, though, man. I got to give them to Zoo. No, I'll wear the Gucci flip-flops, Ramen. Please. Please. These are my flip-flops right now. Please. Please, give me the Guccis. Give me the Guccis. I just got these little avocados. A little old and dirty. Look, they got a hole in them. There's a hole. Ramen, please. I need the Guccis. Please, help me. What else did I miss? Yeah, the doubling down thing is all over the internet. Oh, yeah, it's a huge TikTok thing. Huge TikTok thing. Let's see. Runs out of the building with a strangely large bag. There you go. You guys got the money. I know none of these people. Shit sounds wild. I mean, it just depends on how into Twitch you are. I'm a big Twitch user. I love these streamers. Oh, you know Pokimane? I know I spelled that all fucked up. No, that's how you spell her name. Oh, wait, no E at the end, right? Wait, how do you I just forgot how to spell Pokimane. Oh, no, that's how you spell it. Yeah, that's exactly how you spell it. Will said the vibe at the Streamer Awards is streamers want Kick to be successful to force Twitch to improve. That's exactly what I've been saying. Like, regardless of all the other horrible shit that I've said about Kick and how it's like really not a good platform, I hope that they get their shit together and it becomes an actual competitor to Twitch. Because if Twitch had a competitor, they would have never been able to get rid of the 70-30 split. I was hoping, and I didn't think it was going to happen, but I was hoping that when YouTube was buying all these streamers from Twitch, that that's what was going to happen over there, is it was going to get bigger. And I said that it wasn't. I didn't think that's what was going to happen, but I hoped that it would, just so Twitch would actually have a competitor, because right now, Twitch does not and can do whatever it wants. Literally, I have Twitch for you. That's all. Wait, lovely lady. How did you... Did you like find my Instagram and then make a Twitch account for just to come watch, or how did you come here? I forget. You came in on a raid, didn't you? World is, but yeah, this is gonna be interesting. Trainwrecks and Hassan. XQC calls out Trainwrecks for being a fraud. Okay.
I think she's a solid pick.
Oh no, this is AI. Okay, don't care. Let's see. S-Fan is mad about a 69. Mika's drama watching streamer awards from home.
This is when I see it. All right. Hold on, let me lower it.
Wait, what?
This is when I reacted. Respectfully.
Oh, Mika being a coomer.
And here's when I realized what I just did.
Here,
this
I need.
This is when I realized what I just did.
I want to see the actual clip. I don't want to see her reacting to it. Wait, was she being a coomer? Nice, dude. Here, actually, let's look at here, because I don't see it here. It's probably gone now. Let me try to find it. Oh my god. No. Okay, no, I don't see it here. Maybe if I go to her actual Twitch page. It'll probably be one of the most viewed clips. Oh, here it is.
Flex the rainbow.
See how he's fit in the back? Sorry.
Oh!
Flex the rainbow.
See how he's fit in the back? Sorry.
Everybody. I'm getting money, baby Crockett.
One, two. Sorry.
Okay, wait, hold on. I just dropped a safety pin.
Flex the rainbow.
See how he's fit in the back? Sorry.
Everybody. I'm getting money, baby Crockett.
One, two. Sorry.
Hell no more. Never did anything slow. No,
you nobody saw what happened.
Yep.
No.
Coomer. Coomer. Nope, just clicked a random video. Wait, on YouTube? Or where? That's awesome. Wait, I just saw Cutie was live. I kind of want to see what she's talking about. Is she talking about stream reward stuff, Minx stuff? Let's see.
The order on the envelopes needs to be the order of the cameras.
Oh, okay. No, she's just talking about random stuff from the stream rewards.
On the me problems. All right.
And super TF.
Okay, never mind. Let's go to watch some videos. I think there's a couple more clip videos though.
Cutie Cinderella jokes about XQC's McLaren.
But it's
nice, Volk.
Surely.
Surely.
XQC is also here tonight. He showed up. But it. I'm so sorry. But it's a little confusing because I didn't know you could still drive half a McLaren.
My headphone cable is caught in my chair. Jesus Christ.
Pokemon is here, which makes me so happy. I didn't get to see her as much this year because she's been dealing with some creeps.
Yeah, I'm
pretty excited about it. Yeah. Who are you most excited to interview, would you say?
Your dick?
Yeah.
That's really fair.
Let's go.
Most minions invite the stream rewards.
It's like slapping God on his freaking ass and then asking him to come show up anyways. I don't know why we were nominated if you don't have the respect to give us the time of day.
Is this a protest?
Of course. Lovely lady, of course.
Yep, you got it right on the
door. Of course.
I think they have something. Like
I'm glad you're here. Right now. Oh, but it was here on Twitch. You okay. Cool. Okay, let's check it out.
Good afterthought, like the Chow Garden and Sonic Adventure Battle 2. More like a bad afterthought, like the script and Avatar: The Way of Water.
Yeah, have you ever heard of the franchise Hunger Games? That's my arm right there.
Nice, Volt. Cool. Very cool.
So now we're on protest.
All right, okay. Well, let me ask you guys: what would you, what should you have been nominated for?
Everything.
Yeah, everything. Yeah.
Agreed. They're on to something.
Yep.
Look, let me show you something. What we have here is Brendan Fraser's talented actor bathwater.
Yep.
What? So
when he was filming the whale, after the shoot, he took off the fat suit. And
Bill Clinton shows up.
Playing Ark these days.
How did you get in here? Is that the?
Don't we have security for this?
Like, guys, it's not the Bill Clinton Game Award, kids. It's WANTEP.
Holy sh. They look identical.
Okay, that Volk, I'm just going to say that last message, very questionable. You're getting a little too into the role.
QT tells Jake to get off the stage.
Jake, get the off the stage. What are you doing?
In this moment, I even called it out. I was like, he's supposed to do the double it. The KFC thing.
Oh my God, I forgot.
Mm-hmm.
KFC, thank you so much for this sponsor. I'm so freaking sorry. Jake, you just want to know.
Crip, not a fan of streamers who act like they're living in the clouds when they're just a streamer.
There were a few streamers that they show up at TwitchCon in like sports cars. They rented like, you know, BMWs and crap like that. And some of them were like driven in these cars. Yeah. A few of them were in the hotel room on the same floor as mine, because TwitchCon paid for their room. It was like a 3-minute walk. TwitchCon.
That's funny.
Just pointing that out. Yeah. So, you know, they were making an entrance.
See ya, and he's
cringe.
Arrive at the streamer awards.
So my baby just bought me a Budweiser six pack before
the
I got
best.
Here, and I didn't have anything else to.
This is how you should do the streamer awards: showing up and be like, "I need to look so good." It's like the Oscars. I don't know. To me, things like the Oscars and shit like that are just cringe. I don't like put like actors and things like that up on this pedestal where I think they're so great and we need to watch them go and do this like extravagant thing where they all just like circle jerk each other. I don't give a fuck. This is what you need to do at the Streamer Awards, okay?
There.
This.
So I stuck my phone in there and he said it looked great. So I decided
But
to
I do
it.
Think a lot of streamers love the idea of the Oscars. They love that. So that's what the Streamer Awards is to them. It's them getting to go and finally do their red carpet and look really nice in a dress or a suit.
I tell you, it looks amazing.
This is the way
I mean,
to go.
You guys look awesome. Is there something in particular you're looking forward to during the Streamer Awards right now?
Yeah, Jesus Christ himself.
Yeah.
He walks himself up on that stage and he looks at me and says, "Hell, you coming out with me? Them girl at Pearl of Gates? That's you, buddy boy."
Well, let me tell you, Jesus is in all of us tonight. And
yeah, you got the Holy Spirit in him.
Jesus
amen, brother.
Ludwig asked Bridge a question.
How do you feel? How do you feel about the competition, the other people? It's pretty stacked.
XQC. So it's like, you know, probably going to lose. But, you know, the W and L community is kind of... We're kind of banding together.
Do you think 2023 is the year where the bridge is crossed?
Yeah.
Like PewDiePie style? What do you mean? Racist? He's racist.
No, wow.
Racist. No,
racist
I did.
Here, hold on. We got to hear that again.
Competition. Let me tell you, Jesus is...
Amen, brother.
Ludwig asked Bridge a question.
How do you feel about the competition, the other people? It's pretty stacked.
XQC. So it's like, you know, probably going to lose. But you know, the W and L community is kind of, we're kind of banding together.
Do you think 2023 is the year where the bridge is crossed?
Yeah.
Like PewDiePie style? What do you mean? Racist? He's racist.
No, I don't get it. What does he mean the bridge is like, I don't get what the bridge is crossed has to do with PewDiePie. I guess I don't know PewDiePie lore.
It's weird that he just said that.
Let's go to Sweet Anita. Let's go to Sweet Anita right now.
For you.
Sweet Anita.
Hi, everyone. So we have...
The streamer of the year goes to...
Bro, I was so into like what I was doing with the stream rewards. I don't even remember this guy being there. I don't remember him doing anything.
Goes to...
I don't remember that segment.
And the winner of best streamer.
Oh, wait, never mind. That was just a Kai clip. Never mind. Okay. That was just a clip from Kai's stream. Okay, I remember that. I thought there was like a part where they had the Ben the Talking Dog come out and do like a segment. And I missed it. No. That was just a part of Kai's. Okay.
And the winner of best streamer of the whole entire year is...
Is? Chat? Who it is?
Kai Sinat.
I think it's so cringe that he didn't show up.
Small streamer sees herself.
That's so weird to like be nominated for like streamer of the year and not show up. I don't.
He's in front of 300k. I don't get that. Streamer awards.
I'm gonna cry.
Oh, that's maybe what it was about. I mean, I remember last year. We were saying that leading up until Ludwig said it himself. That's what we were all saying.
No way.
But yeah, and I remember him saying it. Maybe that's what they were talking about.
The winner for best Valorant streamer is Tyday.
She was like, what? She even said she knew the backlash that she was going to get for winning over Tarek.
I didn't have a speech prepared today because I was expecting someone else to win. But I did talk to Cutie on the sideline, and this was my make-a-wish. So thank you very much, everyone. I appreciate it. Thank you.
A lot of people got mad at her for saying that joke. And I've seen a lot of people, like, she'll make jokes about her cancer, like, in her chat. Somebody even made a joke saying she had a leukemia buff because she was, like, doing, like, really good in Valorant. And she laughed at it. And people were like, that's not funny. And they got mad at her for laughing at it. And they got mad at her for, like, saying this joke. And it's like, you guys understand that she has leukemia, right? Like, she's the one with cancer. If she wants to, like, make jokes about it, like, she's the person to do it, okay? Like, let her laugh herself through it, okay? Exactly. Now, some random person out here just making jokes about cancer nonstop, that would be weird. But it's, like, somebody with cancer, like, literally debuting it to everybody. If that's how she wants to cope, like, let her cope. Exactly. Let her cope. Let people cope. Exactly, Danky. What up, Danky?
That was messed up.
Yeah, she's the one making light out of it. And, you know, I think a lot of times, like, people, when you get cancer, you just get depressed and you, like, almost give up, you know? And I think sticking with that positive attitude of just trying to laugh through it, and being like, I'm going to get through this. It's just a fucking joke. I think that is like the mentality like that really helps people get through that kind of shit.
That's.
Dream's friends announce a move to kick on a Twitch-sponsored stream.
Are you going to announce it right
exactly,
now?
Exactly, yeah, lovely lady.
255K.
We're joining kick. Yeah, we're announcing that together. Okay.
I 100% understand what you mean.
Yeah. I want you to
that's
read
for
out
you to
sponsors.
Like cope with in whatever way you want, you know?
We got Fansly, that's really cool. Yeah,
keep going.
Uh-huh. Spotify.
Right.
What is that, Fansly again?
Yeah, Twitch, bro!
Yeah, fuck cancer, right? 100%.
You can't announce that you're on a different... Resub. It's a really...
It feels like the right fit for us, we're super pumped.
Okay, let me ask...
Will you come to the Streamer Awards? What the hell is a Streamer Award, man? No, I don't think
Forcing
so.
No idea what the stream rewards is. He's just doing that on purpose. He knows what it is, but
no,
he's
got to
stick up with
so.
The brand of just being careless and aloof and not knowing anything
rigged events.
Of what's going on.
No, thank you.
Yeah, who's forcing exactly? Who's forcing?
If you guys enjoyed this video,
what
feel
is that?
Free to drop a log. And if you want to keep up with
okay,
the
what are we
going to
watch?
Clips,
we're
sure
done
to
with Twitch clips.
And turn notifications on. and I'll see you guys in the next one.
What do we want to watch?
Can I tell everyone what you smell like?
Yes, of course. Go for it.
I read a horror story about someone who got a manicure once and died from smell. It, so I could never do that.
It's Dick. It's
So good. So good. What a legend.
Twitch streamer and attendee of the Streamer Awards, Justin Minx, tweeted out, that was 100...
Wait, is this anything? No, this we already talked about this. Oh, is Boonie still here? I got a fun video for Boonie real quick that I saved in here specifically for Boonie. Here, if he is, we'll watch it after this. Let's just watch this real quick. I got to go to the bathroom.
Get ready. Yep, okay. Cram it in there then. Will, wait, cram it in there
wait,
then.
Wait, wait.
Will, this is...
Okay, I've made mistakes.
Yeah.
I've made mistakes.
Wait, no.
How you guys feeling today?
Awesome. All right. Yesterday was
we
amazing.
We had so much fun. I was just saying thank you so much. I definitely owe you a dinner in Los Angeles. This trip has been incredible.
You don't owe us anything.
Yesterday was so much.